Hello everyone, I'm Eliana Rich and welcome to my channel. If you are going to have a competition, interview or any other selection process, it doesn't matter in which sphere of your life, in sport or about creativity or private life or career opportunities or maybe business competition, this video is for you. Predictions I'm gonna do with a popular American fantasy television show which is called Game of Thrones. These cards will show us the current situation, what's going on right now, what's happening when you're watching this video. And also it will, show us if this competition is gonna be fair, what kind of unexpected events might happen, and your emotional motivation during this process. Also, we will find out your strengths and weaknesses about you and your competitors. At the end of the video, the winner will be determined by this letter. And I'll show you. This is the letter. This is the wheel where the king, the Robert Baratheon, you see, this is the blood signature. This is the wheel who is gonna be the next king after his death. So this letter we will open later at the end of the video, and we will know for sure if you're gonna be the winner, if you're gonna be the king of this land or not. You can see this is the map of the king's landing. And today we have four options. So one of you, it's you. So pick the one pile for you. And to the others, you can assign your competitors. If you know their names, or maybe it's the companies or organizations, if you don't know who is it, you can just think like this is the competitors, and that's all right. And so below the video, you will find the time coding. And also, I would recommend you to listen for all of them so you will know who you are competing with. You will know their strengths and weaknesses, and it will be helpful for you. All right, let's get started. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button and leave your comments. And now it's the time for the number one. So please think about your situation, interview, or what kind of competition it is. Think about it and let's see what's going on right now. What kind of situation it is right now. And this is Three of Swords. And by Three of Swords, this situation is start up. It's just the beginning. It's not like the middle one, right? Or you see, it shows three. It's not the zero, right? It's not just like gathering information or no. The process is going on very actively, very intensely. You know, it's intensive, Mark. And the dragon, right? It's called dragon. It's showing us like how intense it is, how serious it is, how it's gonna be like very strong competition. Actually, it's not gonna be easy going process. Unfortunately, it's only for very, you know, the strongest, the best one will win. And this is just the beginning. It's still gonna take some time. All right, now let's ask if this competition is gonna be fair, if it's not predetermined already, right? Yes, it is fair. It is fair, and again, we have regal. This is the dragon, and by three and swords, it's saying they're accepting this competition very seriously. Everything they will, learn and study all the applications, documents, or your interviews, or all, the conversations will be taken very seriously. No fun at all. It's not gonna be like easy peasy process, right? No, it's maybe for some of you it looks like it's so small thing, like it's like a funny competition, but no, looks like it is promising. The result will be promising. So by this dragon, yes, so they will take very careful approach to study everything, and then they will reveal the winner, right? By eye, they will determine who is it. And looks like it's gonna be, you know, like not easy decision to make, because the candidates who will be involved in this process, they all gonna be like equal, the same strong ones, and that's why this card is showing it's not gonna be easy for them. They're gonna argue, it's gonna take for them to make their choice, decision, right? Let's see what unexpected events might happen during this process. Something, yes, you know, and it might be not for everyone of you, of course. Not by one, it's the opportunity, so they will think to provide you maybe more tasks to do or more additional question if it's about interview or something, right? It's gonna be something, maybe for some of you it will be required to provide additional evidence, documents, additional information, maybe some of you it's gonna go through some, you know, tasks like assessment to do. It's possible, but not for sure, because by one it's just the opportunities. It might happen, but not for everyone. All right, so be ready. If it will happen, you will know for sure. Some kind of surprise like that might happen. Let's see your emotional motivation, how you will feel emotionally, if you will be very determined to win, or you will feel like you're ready to step back. By six, oh, you're gonna be ready. I think you don't need my comments, right? By this card, you can see this Khal Drogo. He's who is like very strong, very determined. Six of Swords, oh, a lot of... you're so eager to fight, to move forward, to attack, you know? So you're not gonna give up easily. It's a great motivation. With such motivation, there is no chance to lose. Amazing. Okay, now let's ask, what is your strengths and weaknesses at this competition, particular one? Okay, so your strengths, Master of Whispers. Okay, by this card, you are so strong to work with the opponents. You know how to answer them. You know what to ask them. You know how to put them in a very uncomfortable situation, because you're very smart. This is the knife here, right? You're very smart. You have so sharp mind. You know how to use the right, very sharp words and how to ask, and you're so witted person. This is your strengths. And also, you know how to take actions immediately, how to react in the right way. All right, what is your weaknesses? What is your vulnerable moment at this competition? Masters of Ships. Maybe, you know, you don't have the support. Maybe you don't have a strong team around you, or followers, or assistants, or the great specialist around you, or someone who could advise you, you know, give you some very wise advice or something like that. There is the lack of it. And it's saying you need teamwork, or maybe your team is not professional enough or not strong enough. It depends of your competition, right? So think about it, work on it. You still have time to improve this weakness, okay? And I would recommend you to listen for the other three your competitors, so to be, you know, prepared. Good luck. Now let's do for the number two. Number two, let's see what is going on right now. What is the situation is? This is the beginning, and it's, you know, it's something creative situation, or it's about something new or something unusual situation, something absolutely new for you. And also it's something, you know, which they this competition haven't happened before, or maybe it was in a different way, but the, how they are doing it right now, it's very different. You see, it's so mystical, right, looking, and so very extraordinary something. Even if you don't know about it right now, you will reveal it later. It will come up some details about that, right? So interesting. But it's gonna be so, you know, curious, adventurous situation or competition. All right, let's see. Is it competition gonna be fair if it's not predetermined already? No, absolutely not. By zero. There is no predetermination. It is gonna be fair competition. It's gonna be fair interview, right? So you have to show your professionalism, your like your competency, or you know, you have to stay like unbowed, unbent, unbroken. Remember that words. It will be helpful for you. But the good news is, no predetermination. Fair. All right, now let's see what kind of unexpected events might happen during this process. By Four of Swords, yes, it's something might happen, but it's not going to be that crucial or so bad ones. You will be, you know, expecting this one. You will be prepared. That's why the four stands for. It means it will not destabilize you. It will not, you know, to disbalance you. So, but still, it will be a little bit, it will be information, not very, you know, joyful information. You see, that's like intense looking card, right? Drowned man. The by source, it says, yes, you will not like it. It will make you nervous a little bit. It will make you feel like, oh, it's going to be like a fight. It's going to be difficult, maybe a little bit harder than you expected. And it will take some time. You see, it's not going to be very fast till the result, the final result. Okay, no, but good news is you will not be destabilized by that. Some information will be interesting. What it might be for everyone is going to be different, of course. Okay, let's see what is going to be your emotional motivation. Two of Swords, emotional motivation. You will be so strong believer. It's fair competition, and the best, the strongest one will win. By Two of Swords, yes, this is like for the best ones. Like it's gonna be the option, and your motivation is gonna be to try very hard to show, to demonstrate your abilities, your competency to win. Great. Let's ask, what is your strengths and weaknesses at this particular competition? Okay, your strengths and the card, Master of Whispers. It's saying you're a very witted person, sharp-minded. You know how to say, where to say, how long to talk. You know, you're very smart. And when it's a, you know, stressful situation, you know how to focus, how to, you know, like to be concentrated and to be very attentive and to say the right things, you know how to, you know, like right words to say. It's very important, right? That's why it's sharp. Okay, now let's ask, what is your weaknesses? Master of Coin. Mm-hmm. Despite of this card is saying that you are so like witted, quick thinker, right? But this Master of Coin is saying there is maybe lack of, you know, of some abilities to calculate. You know, because about money, it's like calculation or pragmatism. Maybe, you know, you cannot, you can, but you know the perfect one, how to fast, quickly calculate steps ahead of you, you know, to prevent them. This is your weaknesses. All right, think about it, try to improve them within this process, right? And of course, I would recommend you to watch for these three ones to see what is your competitors are about. All right, and then number three, think about your situation. And let's see what's going on right now. This is a serious situation. Five. Okay. So this is this situation is a very it's not easy going process, and they are very picky. They are very serious. They want the best one, but looks like they put some their eye on someone. Approximately they know who they want. But still, it means they will, you know, to go through all this process carefully, and then they will determine the winner. Okay, let's see if this competition is gonna be fair or it is everything is predetermined already. Fair, actually. On this card, they approximately know who are candidates, who are they dealing with, and approximately they thinking who of them might be great, right? But this card is saying there is no predetermination. They will find it out after that interviews or conversations or within this process, right? And then they will determine the winner. Amazing. So don't be afraid, it's not they're not gonna fool you around, right? It is fair competition, so focus, do your best. Okay, let's ask, what kind of unexpected events might happen? By Four of Swords, nothing which can destabilize you. So news, it will be there because it's source, right? News will be revealed for you. But by number four, it will be very stable. And look at this picture. Sir David Seward, right? He's very calm and quiet. It means this news, even it's a little bit unexpected, it will not confuse you. It will not scare you. It will not, you know, bring you some doubts or aggression, right? Or will not upset you at all. And at the same time, it will not make you happier. So it's like neutral information, but still something which will be unexpected. Now let's see, what is gonna be your emotional motivation? Four of Swords, you will be very stable, very steady, and very stubborn. By Four of Swords, look at this card, King's Hunting Party. So your motivation will be like you wanna enjoy. You want to, you know, catch the enjoyment, you want to catch the attention, you're going to catch the great result. And so you are hunting. It is a promising situation. You want to get it so much, and you're very, you know, active and energetic. You're putting a lot of your efforts. You're taking a lot of actions, and you're very steadily moving forward and preparing yourself. Maybe some of you studying a lot, reading, you know, improving your skills by source, or preparing, working on some documents or papers, right? So amazing. Great motivation. Absolutely great. Because what I like about it doesn't drive you crazy. You're very motivated, but you're not crazy about it. Now let's ask, what is your strength at this particular situation? Masters of Ships, your strength is to build up connection with people. Your strength is to get your, you know, like-minded people around you. Your strength is to build up the team, great team, loyal ones, professional ones, and the great ones who are around you, you can trust them. And also, you are absolutely amazing to organize the people around you and everything, right? You're everything you can keep under your control. This is your strength. Okay, now let's ask, what is your weaknesses? Where you're vulnerable at? Crown Regent. Okay, by Crown Regent, maybe it's a little bit difficult for you to redirect quickly when the situation is changing, or topic is changing, or some atmosphere is changing. Maybe you cannot very quickly to switch, to be redirected, to trans, you know, like you need some quick transformation, and for you requires some time, so you can be a little bit confused and disoriented a little bit. This is your weaknesses at this competition. All right, so try to work on it, improve it, and you will be good. Look at this motivation. And of course, I would recommend you to watch for these competitors as well. What are their weaknesses, you know, to use it. All right, next one, the last one. Think about this competition. Okay, what's going on right now? Three of Swords, this process is going on very actively. So they're so busy, or this process is going on and intensely. You can see, right, about a scent. You can see how she's determined to fight, to prepare, you know, to get, to achieve your goals. This is how this current situation, everyone who is involved in this process, they're very, very brave and determined. Okay, so let's ask if this competition is gonna be fair. By three, yes, it is fair competition. First of all, this is the beginning, right? The beginning with the supporters, with the team, and all together, right? And then they will, you know, it takes time, and then they are, you know, going through the documents or applications, or analyzing how interview went, right? How it was, checking their protocols. No, you know how it might be, and then they're taking their, you know, making their decision. So by three, there is no swords. If it would be five, for example, right, or swords right here, I would say this little bit like looks like predetermination is there, but not. This card is saying no, everything is fair, absolutely fair decision. Okay, now let's ask, what kind of unexpected events might happen during this process? Mm. Okay, here you will reveal some information by source, like there is very professional ones involved in this process. Like there are absolute leaders, like top managers or very great and high level specialists, or it depends of your situation, right? So by seven, they are amazing ones. Very competent, very prepared, very educated, skilled, and then you will find out, like, despite of on this, like, absolutely obvious, like qualities, that still everything will be going how it has to go, and then the winner will be revealed, revealed, right? Yeah. So it will upset you a little bit because, the strong competitors, it's a little bit, makes us nervous, right? But we will see who is gonna be the winner. Okay, now let's ask about your emotional motivation, especially after when you will know who is there, what kind of people are around you. Motivation is gonna be, it's called tears of bliss. Look at these tears, like poisoning, right? But it's number one. It's good news because sometimes, your balance inside of you will be, changing. One day you will feel, oh no, I don't want it. It's this, they are too strong to me. And the other day you will feel, no, I can win. I will try. Maybe I'm gonna be like luckier, right? So, despite of this name, the poison, your mood will be very changeable, right? So I would recommend you try stay be very focused, concentrated, right? And your strong motivation will help you. So don't step back. No. Okay, let's ask, what is your strengths at this particular competition? Masters of Whispers, you're so smart. You're so smart. You know a lot. You know how to talk. You know how to keep conversation. You know how to say, when to say, in which word. You're a very witted, sharp-minded person. So, no, don't let yourself to step back. No way. And now let's ask, what is your weaknesses? Where you're vulnerable at? Masters of Laws. Here, maybe your education is not, high enough for this competition, or maybe your skills, like weaker than these ones. Maybe your experience is not good enough, or maybe, what else it might be? Maybe, no. Masters of Law, everything is about qualification, education, skills, experience, knowledges. All right, so this is your weaknesses compared to your competitors. So try to work out it, all right? Good luck. And now it's time for the winner to find out who is gonna win this competition. And let's open the king's wheel. Before we will open it, I'm gonna use these two or four banners, right? This is four houses who is gonna be your competitors. So one of them is you, right? So we're gonna use House Lannister, House Martell, House Tyrell, and House Stark. All right, so randomly I'm gonna pick to those piles. Randomly. Oh. All right. It's gonna be here, it's here, it's here. All right, where is your house? Which one? You know, right? You remember. And now, let's open the will. What it says? We can see here. The King Robert Baratheon, he's willing. I do hereby command Eddard of House Stark is gonna be the king after this one. So the Stark House, this one is the winner. If you pick number 4, you're the winner. You're gonna be the king of this whole landing, right? So it's gonna be amazing. It's gonna be big deal, and big changes are coming into your life. If you pick number 1, 2, or 3, do not be upset at all, because this one is only one chance in your life. What is not for us, what is not ours, that's not coming to us. It means the destiny prepared for you something else, maybe even much better than this competition, all right? So don't be upset and keep moving forward. And one day you will win anything what you want. What is yours will come to you. All right? Good luck. Bye.